I'd like to talk to us from the subject, the parable of the 10 talents. On yesterday, my brothers and sisters, we had our second workshop on maximizing stewardship here at First Baptist Pittsburgh, the three T's, our time, talent, and treasure. And with that, I want to encourage us to make the best of our time, talent, and treasure. Just want to say that we will have these workshops quarterly so that our officers and disciples will understand the importance of being good stewards to what God has entrusted to us. And just as important, we want everyone to take a spiritual gift inventory to see where you fit in. Once you complete this inventory, you can ask yourself these questions. Is there some current place in ministry in my church that I can serve God? Is there a new ministry? Is there a new ministry that God is leading me to start? Is there something that has been put on my heart that God is leading me to discover? I encourage you to make out to the next workshop. Make it to the next workshop to be good stewards of what God has given to us. You know, I can't do it alone. The folks that showed up yesterday can't do it alone. We need you. Matthew 6:21 reminds us that for where your treasure is, there also will be your heart. Giving of your time, talent, and treasure. Your treasure is your time. It is the launch pad. Giving is not required by the law. It's a privilege under grace. The key is starting somewhere with your time, talent, and treasure. We thank God for those who came out Outreach Week using their time. But we need everyone to come out and support venues like that as we look to let folks know this is First Baptist Church, the church where the doors are always open. So let us remember these three points. Coming together is a beginning. Keeping together is progress. Working together is success. Amen goes right there, church. Amen. Luke 6:38 confirms that. It says, give, and it shall be given unto you, pressed down, shaken together, and running over. God will open up a window, my brothers and sisters, as we use the three T's, as we maximize the stewardship. God will open up a window from heaven and shower down blessings too numerous for you to count. C.S. Lewis said in his book, Mere Christianity, every faculty you have, your power of thinking, or the moving, even the moving of your limbs, from moment to moment is given to you by God. If you devoted every moment of your whole life exclusively to his service, you could not give him anything that was not, in a sense, his already. We meet Jesus in the book of Matthew, my brothers and sisters. Matthew, a former tax collector, telling the parable of the talents. In Jesus' time, a talent was the largest unit of currency at that time. The one that had 5 talents of gold would be considered a multimillionaire by today's standards. You heard it in the synoptic rendition earlier on read by Cesar Hernandez, the rendition of the Luke, the physician. It's the same story, but just a different audience. This parable speaks to three principles. Principle of ownership. Psalm 24 tells us, the earth is the Lord's and the fullness thereof, and they that dwell therein. This is a fundamental principle of biblical stewardship. God owns everything that we have. We are simply managers or administrators acting on his behalf. Then there's the principle of responsibility as we look at our text. We are called as God's stewards to manage that which belongs to God. God has graciously entrusted us with the care, development, and enjoyment of everything he owns as his stewards. We are responsible to manage his holdings well and according to his desires and purposes. Then there's the principle of accountability, which we see in our text. That is, a steward is one who manages the possessions of another. We are all stewards of the resources, abilities, and opportunities that God has entrusted to our care. And one day, each one of us will be called to give an account for how we have managed what God has given us. One day we all stand before the judgment seat of God and give an account of what he has given us. Like the servants in the parable of the talents, we will be called to give an account of how we have administered everything we have been given, our time, our talent, and our treasure, which includes also your time, money, your abilities, information, wisdom, relationships, and authority. You're not being a good steward just to be doing it. There is the fourth, and I said it was three principles, there is the fourth principle and a final principle, and that is the principle of reward. Paul reminds us in his letter to the Colossians 3:23-24 says, "And whatsoever you do, do it heartily as to the Lord, and not unto men, knowing that of the Lord you shall receive the reward of inheritance, for you serve Jesus Christ." In other words, we know that the forgiveness of sins has been made possible in everlasting life in reality. My brothers and sisters, as we look at this parable, we see where the servant that had five and the servant that had two was well, was taken in well. But the one that hid his talent, the one that did not want to show that he was a good steward, it says, unfortunately, in the text, where he's going, there'll be weeping and gnashing of teeth. And we find that type of language in the book of Revelation. The Bible shows us in this parable, my brothers and sisters, that the faithful steward who does the master's will with the master's resources can expect to be rewarded incompletely in this life, but fully in the next life. I don't know about you, but we all so long to hear what is explained in our text in Matthew 25:21. After the day is done, after we've sung our last song, after we put up our hymnals, after the last prayer, what we want to hear from our Lord and Savior Jesus Christ, as it says in Matthew 25:21, "Well done, my good and faithful servant. You have been faithful over a few things. I will make you ruler over many things. Enter thou into the joy of the Lord." And you know, joy, if you use joy as an acronym, joy is Jesus, O is others, Y is yourself. Enter into the joy of the Lord. My brothers and sisters, I encourage us as we look out and we see, so glad that you've made it to church, but we want to see the same kind of attendance when we have our workshops as we maximize the stewardship here at First Baptist Church. We need to be faithful stewards of all that God has given us, my brothers and sisters. Has God done anything for you? Has he given you anything? Has he given you anything? He's given us second, third, and fourth chances. He has given us, he said, we can ask the question, how many times must we forgive, Lord? 7 times 77. God, in the person of Jesus and guided by the Holy Spirit, the very breath we breathe, that's God's. The roof over our head, the clothes in the closet, the food on the table, the warm blood that flows through our veins is all because God loves us. And I don't know about you, I'm glad that God loves us. I'm glad God has looked beyond our faults and seen my own. I'm glad, I don't know, but I'm glad that I serve the true and living God. I'm glad that he's still the doctor in the sick room. I'm glad he's still the lawyer in the courtroom. I'm glad. Is anybody in here glad to be a child of the King? Oh, my brothers and sisters, it's a beautiful thing when the children of of God come together. As Deacon Hernandez said in his prayer of all the different things that have been happening and continue to happen, you will look in the mirror and realize how blessed you are. Every day when you wake up, you realize how blessed you are. That if it had not been for the Lord on our side, where would we be? So my brothers and sisters, on the 16th anniversary of 9/11, you remember. But there was something that happened for a score a couple years ago, where they took an innocent man to a hill called Golgotha, who had no sin and knew no sin, and they nailed him to a cross. But I'm so glad that he didn't stay on that cross. As the Bible said, 3 days later, he rose again. That's love. They hung him high and stretched him wide, they hung his head, and then he died. That's love. But I'm glad today that's not how the story ends, because 3 days later, 3 days later, 3 days later, 3 days later, he rose again, and here we sit in these sanctified walls. I pray, my brothers and sisters, as you go through the week, you remember that God's just asking for just a portion of what he's given us. Just a portion, not everything, just a portion. And the more you give, the more you receive. Because we can be God-given, no matter how hard we try. God bless you, and may heaven continue to shine on you.